welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. And as always, great to have you with us at the start of a brand new day. Now, our next guest is considered by some to be part of the next generation of brilliant young artists to come out of South Africa. Carla Franco is her name. And earlier on this year, she released her debut album, Chapter One, to raving reviews. And both of her singles, When You're Ready and Scared to Love, are also have reached number one on the SA Top 20 on Jacaranda FM. Take a sneak peek at this. When you're ready, you can come on, come on. I've been waiting my whole life for this. We can be in love for so long, come on. When you're ready, you can come on, come on. I've been waiting my whole life for this. We can be in love for so long, come on. Can't promise that we won't fight. Ladies and gentlemen, Carla Franco's in the house! Come on! Yes!
Yes!
Carla, I was complimenting you on the album cover. It's a beautiful, stunning photo.
Thank you.
And you say that that's the only normal photo you have?
Yeah, I'm super awkward in front of a camera, like for photos. And people are like, let's take photos. I'm like, let's not.
But we love your energy. I've been seeing you playing around with our photographers on set. You've just... fantastic energy.
Thank you. I really
this time of the morning, all day as well, I'm sure.
Thank you.
And congratulations. The debut album, Chapter One, has done very well. Two number ones. That must be quite exciting. Talk to me about the journey of bringing out your first album and what that was like for you.
Scary.
Yeah.
Scary, because we just have so much talent in our country.
Exactly.
And not that it's a competition, but you know, you want to put a product out that you're proud of.
Yes.
And that's a true testament to your craft. So it was scary.
Yeah.
But also really, really exciting, because I think I finally found my niche.
Mm-hmm.
So I was super excited to finally share that niche with everyone. So once it was released, I think that's when the excitement really started.
Absolutely.
But anything before then, I was like, but you know. We had a great journey creating it, and I've had a really great journey experiencing post-release what's been happening with the album, so, yeah.
Excellent. Yeah. You talk about finding your niche, and I think that's what every artist wants to do.
Yeah.
You know, there's so much influence coming in from the outside world, but ultimately, as an artist, you want to give the world who you truly are, right?
Yeah.
So how did you find that?
I think my roots have always been very indie, acoustic, you know, stripped down, music. That's what I love. The more raw it is, the more authentic it is,
mm-hmm.
the more true to me it will feel. But then you find that balance between creating the music that's true to you, but creating a product that's also sort of like a mishmash of all the things you love. Because like you say, they are influences, and I think I reflect that in my music. I mean, I'm not trying to create one genre, and that's what a lot of artists do, and
yes.
I'm not critiquing that. I just think we can do more than one genre. And
right.
Chapter One really speaks to that. You have the indie, you have the pop, but then you also have the more hip hop, you have the more funk, you have the more, you know, there's a little bit of everything, and that's really on purpose. It's very intentional. So when I say I found my niche, I think I finally just accepted that I was ready to create something that wasn't one sound, but an accumulation of all the sound that I love and the sound that I love to create.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I mean, at the end of the day, it's all music, right?
Yeah.
And if it comes from your heart and it's a part of a depiction of your artistry, then you've served the craft, essentially.
Yeah.
Your vocal influences, I mean, as we were sitting here and you were sound checking, Carl made a comment and said, my goodness, she's got such a unique tone in her voice.
Thank you.
Where do those come from?
I honestly haven't a clue. Like, no one in my family has, you know, many music roots.
Yeah.
So it's just like out of nowhere. But I do think that my hearing impairment has a lot to play with it, because the lower the voice is, the larger the vibrations, the more I can hear.
Oh,
so
wow.
I think when I became accustomed to my lower speaking voice, naturally as a performer, that kicked in.
Yeah.
So it's always hard to answer that question, because I'm like, I just love what I do and I just sing, and I figured I wasn't too awful at it, hopefully.
No. Not with two number one singles, you're certainly not.
Well, I would hope I'm not bad, because that would be rather awful. But no, I don't know. Like, that's just, I've always had a deep voice. I was actually teased quite a bit about it.
Wow.
And I remember my mom said, don't worry, when you get older, this is gonna be it. You know, people are gonna love this deep, husky voice. And I don't like to give my mom the credit and say that she's right. But in that instance, she was right.
Say it to her right there, right there.
No, don't do that. No, joking, love you.
So here you are, chapter one has done amazing work for you, and I'm sure it's going to do even greater things for you. But what's the big dream for you in terms of your music?
Truly to be the next big South African thing.
Come on.
And I don't really mind how big and brave that dream sounds, but
come
that's
on.
It, because I think I'm not necessarily striving for the fame, I'm striving for the platform
right.
that comes with being noticed and comes with that music being recognized.
Yes.
Because they, like I say, I'm very big on local artists and that support. And I think with that platform means more platform for more local artists. So that's the goal.
Wow. Yeah. Well, you certainly have the platform this morning, and we cannot wait to hear you perform.
Thank you so much.
So make sure
thank
that
you for having me.
You're so welcome. Make sure that you do not miss out on that Carla Franco on your Feel Good Breakfast show.